Greetings.
They call us Mohammedans.
What do you call someone who follows a message from a man named Muhammad?
They call us Mohammedans.
What do you call people who follow a religion started by a man named Muhammad?
They call us Mohammedans.
What do you call people who accept the word of one man alone over the combined message of 3,000 years and dozens of prophets of God?
They call us Mohammedans.
What do you call people who think a man named Muhammad is the only messenger they must obey?
They call us Mohammedans.
What do you call folks who swear allegiance to a man as the partner of God?
They call us Mohammedans.
You bet your camel hump I call you Mohammedans.
They call us Mohammedans.
You follow Muhammad's words. You serve Muhammad. You obey Muhammad. You defend Muhammad. You die for Muhammad. In fact, the only thing that blinds you to the fact you worship Muhammad is you have his sock puppet Allah to bow to.
They call us Mohammedans. They say Christian, you worshippers of Christ. Buddhists, worshippers of Buddha.
Christians are worshippers of Christ. Buddhists, worshippers of Buddha. Jews are worshippers of Judah. Oh, wait. Deedat does not make that argument. Nor can he, because he has already explained his theory of the word Judaism.
That portion of land occupied by the children of Judah was called Judea. And the people outside, they said that the religion followed by the children of Judah in Judea is Judaism. That's how this word Judaism came about.
And here his argument falls apart, that we say you are Mohammedans because you worship Muhammad. Not only do Jews not worship Judah, Buddhists do not worship Buddha as God. So really, Deedat only has one example he can attack, and that is because it is the religion Islam is meant to attack, Christianity, the message of the gospel of the Son of God.
Buddhists. And they call us Mohammedans. You know that?
They call us Mohammedans. Now Deedat and Mohammedans do not like the term Mohammedan. In fact, they get rather upset if you call them Mohammedan. They seem to think it means they worship Muhammad. Let me say this clearly to you Mohammedans. I do not think you worship Muhammad. Is that clear? I do not think you worship Muhammad. But you do obey Muhammad's words above the word of God. Mohammedan does not mean you worship Muhammad. We do not think you pray to Muhammad. We don't expect Muhammadu Akbar before you blow yourself up. But Deedat has used flawed reasoning to teach this is the definition of Mohammedan.
They call us Mohammedans. They say that we are the worshippers of Muhammad. No, there is no such creature on earth.
They say that we are the worshippers of Muhammad. No, there is no such creature on earth. Like I said, it actually depends on your definition of Mohammedan. It really does not matter if you pray to his sock puppet or to him.
They don't know that. We didn't correct them. It's Mohammedans. They've been calling us Mohammedans. Worshippers of Buddha are Buddhists. Worshippers of Christ are Christians. Worshippers of Muhammad are Mohammedans.
Mohammedan does not mean you worship Muhammad.
But there is no such creature. There is no worshipper of Muhammad. We are 1,000,000,000 Muslims in the world today. Worshippers of God, God Almighty.
We worship God, God Almighty. Correction, Mohammedans worship Allah and claim He is the Almighty.
Muhammad is a messenger, a prophet. He is no God.
Muhammad is a messenger, a prophet. He is not God. If you are willing to take the word of one man alone, and you obey his words, even if he claims his words come from some deity, but especially when his words refute the God of Abraham, when his words call the God of Abraham a liar, then you have made this man your Allah. And in that case, you do exalt Muhammad. You do worship Muhammad.
But this is the Westerners' way of labeling people.
But this is the Westerner's way of labeling people. Evidently, Deedat is ignorant of the Quran's way of labeling people. Call them pagans when they refuse to follow the pagan deity Allah. Call them infidels who reject faith when they reject Muhammad. Call them apes and pigs. That is the Mohammedan way of labeling people.
We worship Christ, so we are Christian. That guy worships Buddha, so he's a Buddhist. So these guys must be worshiping Muhammad, so call him Mohammedan.
Did you know the word Muslim is supposed to mean submitted to Allah? As long as you know Allah is not the God of the Torah and Bible, I could live with that. Mohammedans are not necessarily called Mohammedans because people think they worship Muhammad. Calling someone Mohammedan does not accuse them of worshiping Muhammad as God. In fact, it is the opposite. Christians know that Muhammad is not God. Christians know that Muhammad did not even speak for God. Psst! Muhammad was not a prophet of God. But Christians also know that Mohammedans raise Muhammad above the Son of God. Mohammedans reject the Son of God because of one man alone, the man Muhammad. And that is a blasphemous stench in the nostrils of God. I use only the term Mohammedan for those of you that follow Muhammad. You do not submit to the God of Abraham. You submit only to Muhammad. So, to call you Muslim is to declare a lie. Please get that straight. I will not lie to you so you feel good about yourself. Now, there is a semantic argument to be made. What if Muslim actually means submitted to the pagan moon deity Allah? If that is the actual definition, if you Mohammedans are willing to declare that Allah is the pagan moon deity, then I could accept your definition. Muslim means pagan worshippers of the moon deity Allah. What say you then? Do you Mohammedans admit you are only following the pagan deity Allah? Or do you Mohammedans still want to think you submit to Almighty God, Yahweh? I suppose that is too much to ask for you to submit to Yahweh, the actual God of Abraham. Nor would it serve Satan's purpose. And the whole reason for Mohammedism is to fill Satan's purpose. Satan wants to trick you Mohammedans into thinking and saying and believing that you are following the right path to God. But that is just one of Satan's lies to you, brother. They call us Mohammedans. This is from a speech Deedat gave in Geneva to a crowd of Mohammedans. It is a speech I have been dissecting where Deedat tries to claim there is no such religion as Judaism or Christianity. Honest to God, I kid you not. Anyway, Deedat has tried to claim Adam and Moses and Abraham and Jesus and everyone and everything is a Muslim. Then he moved on to something that really needed to be clarified. They call us Mohammedans. I think now you can probably understand that Mohammedan is the only accurate term to apply to those who obey Mohammed. If you want to reject the true Injil after you really know what the message of the true Injil was, that is your God-given choice. God will allow you to choose hell with Mohammed, but it will not make him or any Christian happy. O Mohammedan, you owe it to yourself, and you owe it to God, O Mohammedan, to read the true Injil and learn what Jesus really said. Jesus said that he was the Son of God. You can believe the Son of God, or you can believe the man who called him a liar and said God has no son. And if you believe a man instead of God and his son, you do make that man your Allah. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.